Hi there! In this video, we demonstrate the basic functions of the electrical discipline. In the toolbar, activate the building working mode. In the building toolbox, select the suspended ceiling function. Set the mounting height to 2.7 meters and select the center for the placement in room option. To insert a suspended ceiling in a room, simply left mouse click into the room. DDS-CAD offers a bidirectional interface with dialogues and relooks. However, in this video, we demonstrate the integrated light calculation of DDS-CAD. Select the function Light Calculation from the electrical toolbox. Select the option Pick a Room, then press Next. Left mouse click into the room to be calculated. The room data is automatically displayed. You can define calculation parameters. To continue, press the Next button. Using the three dots button, you open the lamps and fluorescent lamp product database. We have selected a standard fluorescent bait infinity 2x36 watts. At the mounting drop-down list, select suspended ceiling, then press Next. Here you can manually edit the number of fittings and their position, and check the calculation results. We'll repeat the same process for all rooms with suspended ceiling. For the office located next doors, we apply the same input values. In the kitchen, we change it to a luminance of 150 lux. In the WC, you can change the maintenance factor to very clean area, then press the Next. Switch the fitting type to lamp. We have selected a wall-mounted glass lamp for wet area 2x75 watts round. Use the same input values for the other WC. Select one of the light fittings, then right mouse click to open the context menu. Select the option Edit Group. Now press the Print button. The Explorer dialog opens with the available report templates. Open EL Light Calculation Report. All the calculator rooms are listed in this report. Once again, select a fluorescent lamp fitting, then open the context menu with right mouse click. Select the option, select objects of the same type as one selected. Next, make a selection window from the lower left corner to the upper right corner with all light fittings included. Open the context menu and select Edit Properties. Activate Render Light On and Fill with Color attributes. Apply the same settings to the lamp fittings. Activate the layer wizard. Move the cursor to the suspended ceiling, then left mouse click when his layer is highlighted to hide it. Now activate the render mode. Rotate the model with the left mouse button pressed until you get to a good view of the rooms. Activate the render ray tracing advanced to generate a render image with light simulation. Open the Switch Product Database from the Electrical Toolbox. The products are sorted by categories on the left. A preview picture shows the 2D symbol. Select the Flush Mounted Switch Single Pole. The switch can be dynamically inserted. Press number 2 on your keyboard to deactivate the grid. With use snap points activated, snap is automatically recognized at 15 cm next to the door opening. With use automatic rotation activated, press Ctrl key and move over a line to rotate the product. Open the socket product database from the electrical toolbox. Select the flush mounted socket single. Place the socket at the same position as the switch in the kitchen. Double-click the socket to open its properties. Open the tab Rod Pause Scale. At the 2D offset field, enter 0.15 meters. An offset of 15 cm is applied only in the 2D socket symbol. Select the Sections function in the toolbar. Press the New Section button. Left mouse click to start the section. Activate the Use Ortho mode to make a straight section. Left mouse click to define the length of the section. Move your mouse to a certain depth, then left mouse click to generate the section. The section has been created in DDS Explorer, double click to open it. Open the layer display. Select Building from the Type drop-down list. Turn on Suspended Ceiling. Select the Distribution Board function from the Electrical Toolbox. Press the New Board button. You can enter a reference description. Press the three dots button to open the Distribution Board product database. Select the Distribution Board category on the left. You can select the first product. Press the Place Symbol button to dynamically insert the board in the model. Activate the Installation System's working mode in the toolbar. Select the Cable Ladder function. Start the cable ladder in front of the distribution board. Set the start mounting height to 2.8 meters. Move your cursor to draw the cable ladder segment. Use left mouse click to insert bands. Draw the cable ladder until the left side of the hall. Press Escape key to terminate the cable ladder function. Activate the reducer function in the toolbox. To insert a reducer to a cable ladder, make sure the Use Smart Snaps function is activated. Enter 200 mm in the width field. Activate the Conduit function from the Installation System's toolbox. Start drawing the conduit at the upper edge of the cable ladder. Start with a mounting height of 2.9 meters. Move along the wall with the conduit and do a left mouse click to end the segment. Open the context menu, select the option End with a junction box. Draw the conduit between the WCs as well. Activate the electrical default working mode in the toolbar. Activate the distribution board function once again. In the circuit list tab, press the new button. Select a supply type from supply generated circuit. Select a fuse. And then a circuit configuration. Now select a protective device. After that, define installation circuit, light with protective device type. You can edit the circuit description and the name offices. Do the same for the next circuit. You can edit the circuit description to WCs. Change the next circuit type to light socket with protective device. You can add the circuit description to kitchen. Once you have finished, press the close button. Select a fluorescent lamp fitting, then activate the Partex function. Press the Configure button. Activate the variables current, cable length to central, and voltage loss. Select the lamp fitting and configure the Partex in the same way. Click on Refresh function in a toolbar. Move the cursor to the bottom of the DDS-CAD interface, then right mouse button to open the context menu. Select the option Distribution Board Circuit List. Select the kitchen circuit and right mouse click. Select the option Draw Circuit. Make sure that Use Smart Snaps is activated. Move the cursor to the cable ladder until it's highlighted, then left mouse click. Press Yes button to allow a cable trunk to be created onto the cable ladder. Now, draw the cable from the cable trunk to the fluorescent fitting. You can deactivate the Use Ortho Mode and use Smart Snaps when they are not required. As the switch doesn't have a junction box, let the cable behind the switch, then press Page Down key. In the absolute Z-Pause field, type 1.05 meters. Activate the Use Smart Snaps again to connect the cable to the switch and then to the socket. And the function with Escape key. Note that this circuit is not connected to the distribution board yet. Go to the start of the cable trunk. Select the cable trunk, then right mouse click on the start node. Select the option Continue from here. With Use Smart Snaps deactivated, left mouse click to the center of the distribution board. With Use Smart Snaps activated, connect the cable trunk to the distribution board. Note that the kitchen circuit is now connected to the distribution board. The Partex has been updated. Select the WC circuit and draw circuit from context menu. This time, start the cable from the end of the conduit. Draw and connect the cable to the lamp fittings and the switch as well. Select the cable trunk at the conduit start. Right mouse click on the start node and select the continue from here option. Connect the cable trunk to the cable trunk on the cable ladder. Note that the circuit is now connected to the distribution board. Now, draw the circuit to the other WC room as well. The Partex have been updated. Activate the office circuit. The same procedure done for the WC circuit will be repeated again here. Select the zoom extent from the toolbar. The electrical modeling is done. To extend the section, select one of the nodes. Extend the section in such a way that you have the distribution board and the cable ladder included. Next, open the section again from the explorer. You can close the distribution board circuit list when it's not required anymore. Activate the cable trunk label function from the electrical toolbox. Attach the label to the trunk with a left mouse click. This is a list of circuits passing through the trunk at this position. Select the part list function from the toolbar. This is a preview of the parts list. You can generate it as a report, export it to Excel, and much more. Save the project, then open the project manager. Select the electrical schematic module and press open. Activate the distribution board function from the schematic toolbox. Select the board from the this board drop-down list. Select the sheets tab, then double-click on the single diagram and multi-man diagram sheet. The diagrams are automatically generated.